What is an IP address? Whenever I look at other people's explanations of this, I have to crack up. I mean, it's like they filled their explanations with all kinds of techno-babble to make them sound super smart. If you really care, IP stands for Internet Protocol. Hell, even if you don't care, it still stands for Internet Protocol. IP numbers look like this. Four groups of numbers separated by periods or dots, as they are most commonly referred to. So this address would be read 69.65.64.123. Without getting all super technical, this is known as Internet Protocol Version 4, or IPv4, and it is running out of addresses, sort of like we ran out of phone numbers, right? So they're coming out with IPv6, in case you want to look all super technical smart. But these numbers still do the same thing. They provide an address to connect devices together so they can communicate with each other. All an IP address is, quite simply, is the address of any device on the Internet, be it your PC, your laptop, your tablet, or even your smartphone. And then, of course, the computer that's serving up the information you're requesting. That includes email, video, music, and even just plain old websites. So, have you ever visited 69.65.64.123? I bet you have, and many times. Just in case you didn't know it, that IP address is google.com. Well, it's one of their IP addresses anyway. They've got more than just one, trust me. So, in old-school technology, think of your device as your home address. To get anything delivered to your home, you have to have an address. The sender also has to have an address. Then think of the Internet as your mailman. He has to know where to pick up all this crap and then where to deliver it.
You've got mail.
Now, I'll cover more about what you can do knowing an IP address in upcoming videos, but for now, comment. Click like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this.